You have to admit, the story you just told me sounds a little unbelievable. First Vladimir's kidnapping, then a mysterious conspiracy, and then men in black robes. On the other hand, the story is so unbelievable that you can't be making it up.
So you'll help us?
Little Nina is in Cuba. With Manuel Perez right now?
Yes, she just sent a picture to my cell phone. I can't understand it, though. Maybe you'll have better luck.
Yes. I've seen this symbol before. But it's been a long time. Vladimir contacted me out of the blue many years after our Tunguska expedition. He wrote in a mysterious letter that he had made a sensational discovery and needed my help. Several years earlier, he had examined a metallic fragment that had been found in the Tunguska region. You've probably never heard of the Kalenkov report, have you?
Just in general. It has something to do with extraterrestrial material, right?
Yes, but that's only half the truth.
What do you mean?
Manuel Perez, who wrote the report with Vladimir, discovered this exact symbol engraved on the surface of the fragment.
You mean there were symbols on the fragment?
Vladimir wasn't sure, since the surface was so severely damaged. During further investigation, he discovered something in the archives of the Academy of Science in Moscow. It was in a report about the research expeditions of an English scientist who apparently discovered disc-shaped artifacts made of unknown material in 1947 during an expedition. This researcher, Evans was his name, described the same material properties that Vladimir had observed on the Tunguska fragment. That alone was a hot lead. But as soon as he saw a sketch Evans had made, it took his breath away.
Why? Please continue.
The artifact was covered with unfamiliar symbols. One of the symbols was the same symbol that Perez and Vladimir had discovered on the Tunguska fragment.
Phew. Sounds exciting. Where did the discs come from? And where did this Evans guy find it?
That's also what Vladimir wanted to know. But he couldn't find anything in the Moscow Academy's records. That is why he contacted me. Vladimir had found out that Evans had died recently, and his personal notes and journals were supposed to be auctioned off in London. He asked me to get the documents for him, since he couldn't leave Russia at that time.
And did you get the documents? Where did this metal disc come from?
I sent Vladimir an encoded copy of the journals. I still have the originals here.
Really? Can I see them?
Just a minute. They have to be here somewhere.
Nina, I have news.
Could this Morangi be of help to us?
I have to say yes. Do you know about your father's expedition to China? To be more exact, to the Himalayas.
He took a lot of trips before my mother's death. It's possible that he was also in the Himalayas. Why?
I think that he was looking for something there and maybe even found it. Maybe that's also the reason he disappeared.
I don't get it.
I'm gonna send you a few things to your cell phone. You better get going right away. I'll meet you in your father's apartment.
Nina still isn't here. I'll give her a call and see where she is. Oh, I have a voicemail message. That's probably Nina, running a little late.
This is Kunsky. I really hope you're getting this message. We have to meet urgently. It's very important. I can't go into details at the moment. I think I'm being followed. I'll try to lose the guys and then go to the museum. Please hurry. I have reason to believe that you're in great danger. I have to go. Somebody's coming. I'll wait for you at the museum.
What is Kunsky doing here again? I don't want to run into him again. On the other hand, the message sounded important. What if it's a trap? I'll probably regret it, but maybe he really does have information that could help us. Nina isn't here yet, and the museum isn't that far away, so I'll just head over there.
Yes?
We've managed to track them. We know where the hideout is.
Are you sure?
The information is absolutely reliable.
Very good. You must go there immediately. I'll tell Professor Charleroi that she should prepare the last phase of the project.
Okay. Once I've found it, what will happen to the girl and her friend?
Well, those two could actually be a problem. Take care of it.
Oh my god, that's Konski! I don't feel a pulse. He's dead. What have I gotten myself into? Kidnapping was bad enough, but murder? I should get out of here.
Max Gruber.
Yes.
Get in, please.
What's keeping Max? He should have already been here by now.
Maybe he had a more pressing engagement.
How come? What do you mean?
You really don't know? Love really does make you blind.
What?
Think about it. Your father disappears. Max sits in the next office and says he didn't notice.
He had his music.
Who urged you to go home and wait for your father there?
It was Max. So what?
So what? Have you already forgotten that's where someone knocked you out?
No, but...
And then the attempt on the train. This has to have something to do with you or your father. That's clear, isn't it?
Yes, but...
Your father wasn't on board. And who knew you were on the train, other than us?
I know that all sounds strange, but...
Nina, wake up. I don't know who Max is working for or what he's up to, but he's playing some kind of evil game, and he's playing it at your expense.
Do you think we should...
Forget Max. I know you like him, but he was only using you. If we don't go now, he'll win the game, and your father will lose.
Maybe you're right. So what do we do now?
The trail to your father leads to the Himalayas. And at least we have parts from a travel journal by this Evans.
We should be able to use it to find the hidden caves of those mysterious mountain people.
And then what? That won't bring my father back.
I know. But I'm sure this strange alien artifact has something to do with your father's disappearance. I admit, we most likely won't find your father in the Himalayas. But at least we have another lead.
Yeah, I know. It's just that I'm so very tired.
Do you want to give up on your father?
No, you're right. Let's go.
Caves are unknown. Without the exact information from Evan's report, no one would ever find their way up here.
Let's hope that you are right. We are, you know, in the border area, and I really do not want to make the acquaintance of overly nervous border patrols. I'll stay at the entrance and keep an eye out. Let me know when you have found something.
An excerpt from the travel journal of a certain Dr. Evans. My father considered getting these documents to be so important that he intentionally coded all documents that deal with the subject. For sure. Without Oleg, I never would have found this cave. Oleg is standing guard. I'm sure he'll notify me in time if problems should arise. A small round hole in the rock. it could come from a yak. It could come from a yak. A wooden peg. The poor guy must have fallen in there. I wonder if he was a member of my father's expedition. I can't reach it from here. Patterns were chiseled into the rock here. I wonder what they mean. The water is crystal clear and most likely ice cold. Pretty big rock. It's too heavy. I can't move it. Lucky that there is another drain, otherwise the entire cave would probably be underwater already. The bag was next to the skeleton, and the rising waters brought it to the surface. This means that the contents can't be that heavy. Oh, a bone. It looks weird, somehow unnatural. The bone caught on something. I can't get it out anymore. Patterns were chiseled into the rock here. I wonder... This room emanates a weird atmosphere. I can't describe it exactly. Unreal, as if one is entering a different world. The head was chiseled directly out of the massive rock face. These lines and circles look almost like the sketches that Manuel Perez made in Cuba. Small humans flee from a huge unshapely object into a cave. It depicts the fall of a huge unshapely object. The broken down trees around the crash site remind me a bit of photos that I once saw of the Tunguska region after the 1908 catastrophe. There's this light coming up from down there that bathes the room in this strange atmosphere. Strange disc. Really looks rather insignificant, but it feels warm, and I have the feeling as if some sort of weird energy is emanating from it. I'll show it to Oleg. Maybe he's got an idea about what we should do with it. Oleg! I was just coming to you.
I see you really did it. Congratulations. We were not mistaken about you.
Thanks. What do you mean by...
I'll explain that later. The boss is waiting. Kambursky to station. Requesting permission to land.
Ah, Oleg, I heard you actually found this metal thing?
Hello, Sergei. Yes, everything actually went as we hoped. The girl was really good.
Excellent work. The boss will be pleased.